going. No one at bell ain't even rung yet. Go back to sleep.
I want to beat the other fellas to the street. Don't want anyone to see I ain't been walking so good.
Oh, quit griping. You know how many fellas fake Olympus sympathy? That bum leg of yours, it's a gold mine.
Someone gets the idea I can't make it on my own. They'll lock me up at the refuge for good. Now be a pal, Jack. Help me down.
Whoa!
Hey! Whoa! You want to bust your other leg too?
No.
I don't want to go down. Take a moment. I'm drinking my penthouse. High above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Oh, what? Is it like a breath of fresh air? Is it like seeing the sky and the stars?
Seeing stars, all right.
The streets down there. Suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs, stomped on by bosses. When they was finally done with them, they tossed them to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
Oh, New York's fine for those that can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But I tell you, Crunchy, there's a whole other way out there. Keep your small life in the big city. Give me a big life in a small town. They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away. To a little town out west that's spanking new. And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day. If you want, I bet you can see it too. It's clean and green and drink. And they went and made a city out of clay. By the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son. Welcome home to Santa.
My lips,
They still dingling.
Ooh, a pretty girl.
A leg of lamb. Hey, get my cigar. You'll feel our nada.
Hey, look. It's bath time at the zoo.
I thought that I'd surprise my nada.
If you can find a...
Who asked you?
Like they used to. I should find me and tell them five great ideas.
From Model Molly to the harbor, there's easy chickens guaranteed.
Try any bank, a bump or comma, they almost all know how to read.
It's a crooked game we're playing.
Yeah.
put that snooze on.
Make way, step aside.
Oh, dear me, what is that unpleasant aroma? My feet are so as may have backed up during the night.
Or could it be?
The Lancy Brothers!
Hey, Oscar, word on the street said that you and your brother took money to beat up striped and trolley workers.
So, as on us walk.
But cracking the heads of defenseless workers.
I take care of the guy who takes care of people.
Hey, did you follow one of the strikers?
I guess he didn't take care of me.
Hey! Lousy crap!
That's the one! Yes, stump some!
Yeah! One unfortunate day, you might just find you got a butt game of your own. Looks like a bunch of us picking on you! Maybe we'll just find out!
Wait till I get my hands on you!
I just want what I paid for.
Is that big?
New kid's right, Weasel. You only gave him 19. Now, I'm sure this was an honest mistake. On account of Oscar, can't count to 20 with his shoes on.
Here. Now, take a hike.
And give him another 50 papes as well.
I don't want more papes.
Well, what kind of a newsie don't want more papes?
I'm no cherry case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
This here is the famous Jack Kelly, once escaped from prison on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage. Made all the papes.
How old are you, kid?
I'm 10. Almost.
All right, listen. If anybody asks, you're 7. Younger sells more papes. And if we're gonna be partners...
Who said we wanted to be partners?
A settlement with Jack is a chance of a lifetime. You learn from him, you learn from the best.
Well, if he's the best, what's he need with me?
Well, because you got a little brother and I don't. I mean, look, that puss could easily sell 1,000 papes a week. Look sad, kid. Oh, we're gonna make millions.
This is my brother, Davey. I was.
Oh, nice to meet you, Davey. Listen, my two bits come off the top, and we'll split the rest, say 70-30.
50-50? You wouldn't try to pull a fast one on a little kid.
Well, then 60-40, and that's my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
It's just business. Newsies, hit the streets. The sun is up, the headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
Circulation has been down since the war ended.
Whoever said war as hell wasn't trying to sell newspapers.
We could use an exciting headline.
What have we got today?
The trolley strike?
That's not exciting. It's epic!
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why.
And besides, the strike's about to be settled anyways. Governor Roosevelt just put a support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist.
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Football. Violent! You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer, please, you must try to stay still.
Gentlemen, you're making Nunzio nervous. When Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How am I supposed to influence voters if they're not reading my opinion?
Big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flash photos or headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before our eyes. You're just not thinking this through, people. Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment, and that's in the bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer, please!
Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close, and you might cut my throat. Just the simplest solutions can bolster the bottom line.
But how does it help us sell more papers?
You don't sell papers, silly. Newsies sell papers.
I've got it! Right now, we charge Newsies 50 cents for 100 papers.
Yes.
But if we raise the price to 60 cents...
Now you're getting somewhere!
Mere tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single Newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to earn the same amount as always.
My thoughts exactly. It's genius!
It's gonna be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'll be giving them a real-life lesson in economics. I couldn't offer them a better education if they were my own. A week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay them more. Turn the shirt on your shoes, boys, for God's sake, relax. Wind on the mountain, all we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons. Bless me.
When you're stuck in the muck, you'll be fine.
And the power of press.
Yes.
Once again, time. The price for the Newsies goes up in the morning. Just a few comments. Yes. That's the bottom.
Very welcome. It's income for you. And I keep that bottom line.
Shut down, watching all the ladies.
sing him to sleep, why don't you? Give me that here. Extra, extra! Terrified flight from burning inferno! You heard it right here! Extra, extra! Oh, well, mister.
You just made that up.
I did not. I said he heard it right here, and he did.
My father taught us not to lie.
Well, mine told me not to starve.
Hey, just sold my last paper.
I got one more.
Sell it or pay for it.
Give it here. I have paid for a poor orphan boy.
Oh, you dear thing. Of course I'll buy a newspaper. Here's a dime.
Born to the breed.
This is so much better than school.
Don't even think it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
All right, so how's about we divvy up the cash, get some chow, and find you somewhere safe to spend the night?
We gotta get home. Our folks will be waiting dinner.
Oh, you got folks, huh?
Does it everyone?
Our dad tangled with a delivery truck on a job. He messed his leg up bad, so they laid him off. That's how come we had to find work.
Well, that makes sense. Too bad about your dad.
Why don't you come home with us for dinner? Our folks will be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Well, thank you for the invite. But I just remembered I got plans with a fella. He's probably waiting on me now.
Is that the fireman?
Kelly!
Run for it!
Officer Crackman! Shoot! Kelly! Stop! Kelly!
Tell me why I'm running? I got no one chasing me. Who was that guy?
That was Snyder, the spider. A real sweetie. Runs a jail for underage kids called the Refuge. More kids he locks up, more money the city pays. Problem is, all the money goes right into his own pocket. Do yourself a favor, stay clear of him and the Refuge.
Hey, you up there! Shoo! No kids allowed in the theater.
Not even me, Miss Meta.
Jack Kelly, man of mystery, get yourself down here and give me a hug. Where have you been keeping yourself, kid?
Oh, never too far from you, Miss Meta. Gentlemen, may I introduce Miss Meta Larkin, greatest star on the Bowery today. She also owns the joint.
Oh, the only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure, gents.
A pleasure. What's the matter with you?
Are you blind? She's got no clothes on.
That's her costume.
But I can see her legs.
Well, step out of his way so he can get a better view. Theater's not only entertaining, it's educational. Got the picture, kid.
Miss Meta, I got a little situation out in the street. Do you mind if I hide out here a while?
Well, where better to escape trouble than a theater? Is Snyder after you again?
Hey, Jack, did you really escape jail in the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
What would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
Just so happens he was running for office. Wanted to show he cared about orphans and such. So he was getting his mug in the paper. I got my butt in the back seat, and off we rode together.
You really know the governor?
He don't. But I do. Say, Jack, when you get some time, I want you to paint me another one of these backdrops. This last one you did is a doozy. Folks love it. And things have been going so well that I can actually pay.
Oh, I couldn't take your money, Miss Meta.
You paid her back?
Your friend is quite an artist.
Oh, don't get carried away. It's just a tree.
You're really good.
That boy's got natural aptitude.
Jeez, I never know one with aptitude. You're on.
I am. Well, how am I doing? Boys like the dorm stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin.
Thank
my investments and such have all gone up so much. Seems whatever I touch starts to rise. I've been all kinds of lucky, and yet the thing I want most I can't get.
Thank you. sirens kept me awake all night.
You know, sirens is like lullabies to me. The louder they wail, the better the headlines. And the better the headline, the better I eat. And the better I eat,
the further away from you, I sleep.
Good morning, everybody. Sorry, but like, we had to help our mom with something.
They got a mother? I was gonna get me one. What'd you do with the one you had?
He traded up a box of cigars.
They was Coronas.
He has a mother, too.
A mother and a father?
Ain't we the hoi polloi?
So how's it going today?
Ask me after they put up the headline.
Here comes Matt.
No Newsies price. 60 cents for 100.
What'd you say?
Is that news?
It is to me.
They jacked up the price of the pigs. 10 cents more for 100.
Well, I could eat 2 days on a dime.
We'll be sleeping on the streets.
You already sleep on the street.
In a worse neighborhood. What are y'all standing around for?
Get a load of this, Jack.
Like bullets that don't make enough already.
Thanks for the Newsies.
Relax, fellas. It's gotta be a gag.
Line up, boys.
Good joke, Weasel. Really got the fellas going. I'll take my 100 and be on the way.
100 will cost you 60.
Well, I ain't paying no 60 cents.
Then make way for someone who will.
You bet. Me and my fellas will take a hike to the Journal.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll save you the walk. They up their price, too.
Well, then we'll take our business to the sun.
Yeah. The same all around town. New day, new price.
Well, why the jack up?
For them kind of answers, you're gonna ask a little further up the food chain. So you're buying or moving on?
Come here, fellas.
They can't just do that,
well,
can they?
Why not, huh? It's their paper.
It's their world.
Ain't we got no rights?
We got the right to starve. Now let's get our papers and hit the streets while we still can.
At them prices?
We got a choice.
Hold on! No one's paying no new nothing.
So, you got an idea?
Would you keep your shirt on? Let me think this through.
Come on, Jack.
What's your answer?
No crowding hands! Let the man work it out! Hey, Jack, you still thinking?
Sure he is. Can't you smell smoke?
All right, here's the deal. We don't sell papes, then no one sells papes. All right, no one goes back to that window until they put the price back where it belongs.
You mean like a strike?
Well, you heard Davey. We're on strike!
Hold on!
Yeah. I can't shut this place down just like them workers shut down the trolleys.
And the cops will bust our heads. Half them strikers is laid up with broken bones.
Oh, the cops ain't gonna worry about a bunch of kids. Ain't that right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. I'm just here trying to feed my family.
Oh, and the rest of us is just on playtime? Just cause we make pennies don't give no one the right to rub our noses in it.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
What if I says we is?
There's a lot of stuff you gotta have in order to be a union. Like, membership.
Well, what do you call these fellas?
Aye.
And officers.
I nominate Jack president.
Yeah! I'm touched.
How about a statement of purpose?
Oh, must have left it in my other pants.
What's a statement of purpose?
A reason to perform at the union.
Well, what reason do the trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
Don't need that. You know, I bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papers right now. Yeah?
Yeah.
So, a union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union we stand! Hey, that's good. Somebody write that down.
I got a pencil.
Meet our Secretary of State? Yeah. What's next?
If you want to strike, the membership's got to vote.
So let's vote. Fellas, the choice is yours. Do we roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets? Or do we strike?
Strike!
You heard the voice of the membership. The Newsies of Lower Manhattan are now officially on strike. What's next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
Well, it'll be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself!
And who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I don't know. I guess you do, Mr. President.
That's right. We do. And what do we tell them?
The newspaper owners need to respect your rights as employees.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they gotta respect the rights of the working kids in this city.
They can't just change the rules when they feel like it.
That's right! We do the work, so we get a say! We got a union. Pulitzer and Hearst, they think, what, nothing? Are we nothing?
No! They need to understand that we are not slaves. We're free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The News Boys Union. And we mean business.
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so.
Other kids from coming along and selling our tapes.
Oh, just let them try.
No, we can't beat up on other kids. We're all in this together.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Are we ready?
Yeah!
What's it gonna take to stop the scabbers? Can we do it?
Yeah!
We'll do what we gotta do until we break the will of grinding land.
Water for you. A water for you. Hmm.
one for you. And for you. And, who was the big spender who ordered the seltzer?
Over here.
And that'll be 2 cents?
2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Or just give me water.
How could I ever guess?
I'd say we launched our strike in the most auspicious manner.
What?
I don't know about that, but we sure scared the demons out of Weasel!
Yeah!
Did you see the Dolantes? They didn't know which way was up!
Yeah. What's next?
Now you gotta spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
Well, you heard the man. Spread the word!
I got Harlem.
I got Midtown. I got Bronx.
And I got the Bowery.
Specs, you'll take Queens. Tommy boy, you got East Side. And who wants Brooklyn? Oh, come on. Brooklyn, spot Conlin's turf. Finch, you're telling me you're scared of Brooklyn?
I ain't scared of no turf. Hey, but that spot Conlin gives me a little...
All right, then me and Davey will take Brooklyn.
Me? I have to...
Why is everybody so scared of Brooklyn?
What are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Well, Brooklyn is the sixth largest city in the world. You hit Brooklyn, you got the mother load. You know, for someone who works for the Sun, you sure spend an awful lot of time hanging around the world. What's the deal with that? You following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins looking to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you got a chance?
Well, shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult. I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York City give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't even got a nickel to their name?
Hey, you don't gotta be insulting. I got a nickel.
Yeah. So, I guess what you're trying to say is you're a couple of Davids looking to take on Goliath.
We never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
You know, I've seen a lot of papers in my time. I never know to know girl reporter writing hard news.
Well, wake up to the new century. The game's changing. How about an exclusive interview?
Ain't your beat entertainment?
Well, this is entertaining, so far.
Oh, yeah, what's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
Oh. You're out of your league, Kelly. Me thinks the lady needs to be handled by a real man.
You thinks wrong, Romeo.
Oh, how'd you know my name?
I say, we saving the exclusive for a real reporter.
You see anyone else giving you the time of day? All right, look. I know I'm just busting out of the social pages. But you give me this exclusive, let me run with the story, and I promise you, I will get you the space.
You really think we could be in the papers?
Stop a paper like the world? You're gonna make the front page.
You want a story? Be at the circulation gate first thing tomorrow morning, and bring a camera. You're gonna want to get a picture of this.
Yeah!
All right, play outside, boys. I gotta get set up for dinner. I got paying customers who need those tables.
Yeah, come on. We got
newsies
to visit.
Yeah, you must be shooing us off. We get our mugs in the paint.
That's for sure. And the world will know. We need keep it score.
Are you kidding me?
Well, you're an artist. You've got real talent. You should be inside the paper illustrating it, not outside hawking it.
Well, maybe that's not what I want.
So tell me what you want.
Can you see in my eyes?
Have you always been their leader?
Oh, I'm just a blowhard. Davey, he's the real brains.
Modesty is not a quality I would have pinned on you.
Have you got a name?
Oh, Catherine Plummer.
Well, what's the matter? Ain't you sure?
It's my byline, the name I publish under. So, tell me a little more about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
Well, I'd rather tell you what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Well, today we stopped the Newsies from carrying out papes, but the wagons, they still deliver to the rest of the city. Tomorrow we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? Yeah, but ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Well, hold on, where are you running off to? It ain't even supper time yet.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, Plummer, write it good. We've both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. On the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. What if only I could just write about it? Come on, Catherine. These boys are counting on you. Oh, you poor, poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady. Don't screw it up. This is not some little body.
Mistake. and about 20 of his gang.
And damn, Brooklyn voice is big.
I gotta say, Spot was pretty impressed.
I'd say.
So they're with us?
Well, that all depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, then they're with us.
They wanted proof we're not gonna fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not. There's us, and there's Harlem.
Boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do first.
Well, what about Queens?
Queens said they'd be right here with us.
Yes, yeah.
As soon as we get the nod from Brooklyn.
I got the same fisheye in Midtown.
Say, Oscar, looks like we've got bum information about strike happening here today. Not that I'm complaining. My skull busting arm could use a day of rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Sure we are.
Maybe we should put this off a few days.
No, we can't. Say something. Tell them if we back off now, they will never listen to us again.
Listen, fellas, you can't back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show. Like it or not, now is when we take a stand.
What if we just don't show up for work? That'll send a message.
They need to see us stand our ground. Maybe.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find our way. But let us seize the day.
Specs. Any sign of reinforcements? Maybe.
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we raise our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey. Stand side by side, too few in number and too proud to hide. Then say to the others who did not follow through, you're still our brothers and we will fight for you. Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday we come somehow, and a prayer becomes a vow, and the strike starts bright day.
Now,
the sun is up and the birds is singing, a beautiful day to crack some skulls, eh? Step right up and get your newspapers.
We weren't gonna trespass. What's your pleasure?
Who are they?
Scabs, what do you think?
They can just waltz in here and take our jobs.
We can take them.
Let's do some more.
Yeah, yeah. We're standing together. We don't have a chance. Jack!
Fellas, listen, I hear you. Listen, I know someone put you up to this. Probably paid you extra money too, yeah? Well, it ain't right. Pulitzer thinks we're gunner rats. With no respect for nothing, including ourselves. Is that who we are? Well, if we stab each other in the back, then yeah, that's who we are. But if we stand together, we can change the whole game. And it ain't just about us. All around this city, there's boys and girls who should be out playing, going to school. Instead, they're slaving for themselves and their folks. Ain't no crime being poor. And not one of us complains if the work we do is hard. All we ask is a square deal. So fellas, for the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse in this city, I beg you, throw down your opinions and join the strike.
Please.
I'm with ya.
Yeah.
Now's the time to seize the day.
Call it your delay.
Hands, we call it.
on a hand like. Nose he's crushed as bulls attack. Crunchy's calling me. Don't crimp's just too damn slow. Folks are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go.
Front page, and you ain't even dead. Where's me? Wait till my old man gets a load of this! I won't be last in line for the top tonight!
You got us in the paper.
You got yourselves in the paper.
Hey, fellas, get a load of this! Newsies, stop the world! Now that's a headline even Alma could sell.
What else do you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer put a blackout on all strike news, so even I'm shut down now.
Were they arrested for much? Would they get Jack too?
The Lancer is spreading the story that he took it on the lamp first sight of the cops.
Jack don't run for no fight.
Oh, take it down, shortstop. Just reporting the news.
Oh, for jumping Jack's sake, can you stow this curiosity long enough to just drink in the moment? I'm famous.
What of it?
Well, you stupid or what? When you're famous, the world is your oyster.
Yo, what?
Your oyster. Your oyster. Your fancy clam with the pale and sore.
Well, how much does being famous pay?
You don't need money when you're famous. They can do whatever you want. Grace, such as a pair of new shoes with dimensional laces. In box that you can't break fish. Drunk on Broadway, shower fish.
I'm going, 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 going
Dear Jack, greetings from the refuge. How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder, so real good with my crutch. Oh yeah, Jack, this is Crutchy, by the way. These here guards, day is rude. They say, jump or you jump or you're screwed. But the food ain't so bad, we so far. Cause so far they ain't promised no food. Ha ha. I miss the rooftop. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down and take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my leg still ain't right. Hey, but Pulitzer, he's going down. And then Jack, I was thinking we might just go, like you would say. One thing I need you to do. On the rooftop, you said that a family looks out for each other.
Santa Fe? Hey, you see the paper? We're front page news. Above the fold. Oh yes, above the fold.
Good for you.
Everybody wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly. Even Spot Collins sent a kid just to say, next event you can count on Brooklyn. How about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
They got us this time, I'll grant you that. But we took round one, and we pressed like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie that could walk showed up this morning, like the strike never happened.
And I was there with them. If I don't sell papers, my folks don't eat.
Saving breath. I get it, it's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face. He was actually nervous. And I realized this isn't over. We got them worried, really worried. And I started to walk away. Lots of other kids did too. And that's what you call a beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
Oh, for crying out loud, what's a fella gotta do to get away from you folks?
There's no escaping us, pal. We're inevitable.
So what's the story? Can we have the theater?
Pipe down. I didn't ask yet.
What's the hold up? I need to let my girl know we've got a date.
Your girl.
You heard me. I've been swatting skirts away all morning. Babe is one intoxicating potion. And this here girl, Sally, she's a plum.
Word is you wrote a great story.
You look like hell.
Hey, Jack, where's that supposed to be?
That's Santa Fe.
I've got to tell you, Jack, this go west young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. Then he died.
Paper quote is supposed to be nonpartisan.
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in this town.
Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have a theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally, a citywide meeting where every newsie gets a say in a vote. And we do it after working hours, so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Yeah, smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy?
Oh, you want to see a place I've seen? How about this? Newsy Square. Thanks to my big mouth, filled to overflowing with failure. Chase hurts, others arrested.
Lighten up, no one died.
Oh, is that what you're aiming for? Go on, call me a quitter, call me a coward, but there is no way I'm putting those kids back in danger.
We're doing something that's never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from Crunchy at the refuge. I tried to go see him. Climbed all the way up the fire escape. But he couldn't even come up to the window, busting his leg so bad. What if he don't make it? Are you willing to shoulder that for a tenth of a penny of paper?
It's not about pennies. You said it yourself. My family wouldn't be in the mess we're in if my father had a union. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd show up to church.
Tell me how quitting does Crunchy any good. Exactly. So, here's how it goes. Once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
Tell me what?
We're already winning.
Right.
I won't tell them straight out, man, like Crunchy, or they keep getting counted.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle.
Right.
Jackie, think about it. We got dance around it.
Here's what I think. Joseph Jerk, he's a rattlesnake.
You're right, and you know why a snake starts to rattle.
No, why?
Cause he's scared.
Sure.
Go and look it up the book. Jack's head is spinning. Why would he send for the goons? An entire army, dozens of goons, plus the cops,
eh? No, you might be right.
Thank you, God.
He wasn't afraid.
Exactly. He knows we're winning.
Yeah, those kids, you see we're sad with me.
Sympathy for the trolley workers, but none for the newsies.
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The newsies are striking against me.
I would save you this embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is private property.
He can't order a raid without legal cause.
Mr. Mayor, will the fact that this rally is being organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. Convicted thief, wreaking mischief amongst our law-abiding community? Which one is he, Mr. Snyder?
That one there, Jack Kelly.
And how do you know this boy?
His is not a pleasant story. He was first sentenced to my refuge for loitering and vagrancy, but his total disregard of authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief and an escaped convict.
After his release, I caught him myself red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was last sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So you'd be doing this city a favor by removing this criminal from our streets.
If that's the case, then we can take him in quietly and—
What good would quiet do? I want a public example in—
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
Just outside. He's asked to see you.
Well, ask and ye shall be received. Mr. Snyder, if you please, sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Afternoon, boys.
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer? Or petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? That's a laugh. No, I just stopped by with an invite. Seems a few hundred of your employees are rallying to discuss recent disagreements. Thought it only fair to let you state your case directly to the fellas. What do you say, Joe? Mind I save you spot on the bill?
You are shameless and disrespectful of a creature, as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting a war.
Oh, yeah, and how'd that turn out for you?
You taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
Well, I'll keep that in mind when New York City wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Oh, rally until the cows come home, but not a paper in town will publish a word. And if it's not the papers, it didn't happen.
You know, you might run this city, but there were some of us that can't be bullied, even some reporters.
Such as that young woman that made you yesterday's news? Talented young girl. Beautiful as well, don't you think?
Well, I'll tell her you said so.
Don't worry, she can hear for herself. Can't you, darling? Jack, I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Mm-hmm. Yes, my daughter. I bet you're asking yourself, why the nominal plume, and why does my daughter work for me? Great question. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure, but instead she chose to pursue a career. And she was showing real promise until this recent lapse. But you're all done with that now, aren't you, sweetheart?
Jack, I—
Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has enough on his plate as it is. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Hello, Jack.
Oh, does anyone else feel a noose tightening? Oh, allow me to offer an alternative scenario. You attend your rally and speak against this hopeless strike, and I see your criminal record expunged and your pockets filled with enough cash to carry you on a first-class train compartment
from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
Oh, there ain't a person in this room that don't know you stink.
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy, to find me looks like you. Little friends locked up in the refuge. You may be Mr. Tough Guy, but it's not right to condemn that little crippled boy to those conditions. And what about your pal Davy and his baby brother? Ripped from their loving family and tossed to the rats? Would they ever be able to thank you enough?
Time's running out, kids, so what do you say? Cowboy or convict, I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest off to the cellar so that he may reflect in solitude. Too bad you've no job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you've no family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy, I'd say that's the bottom line.
Too late.
Till those kids all believed you were right.
Lucky for them, all but one got away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
We've been given discretion to handle these receipts, so behave.
But just in case, I've been polishing off my favorite brass knuckle.
You sleep right here in this old print press. Now that is firm.
Thank you.
you made.
How did you get up here?
Specs showed me.
Did he say you could go through my stuff, too?
It was sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings. They're the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? Three boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
A little differently from where you were raised.
My father told me you were arrested, stealing food and clothing. You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you're willing to go to jail for them, how could you turn your back on them now?
Oh, I don't think you're anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I never lied. I just didn't tell you everything.
Well, if you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You never asked my real
name. Oh, I wouldn't think I would have had to unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
Well, and if I were a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye.
Oh, don't let that stop you. Give it your best shot. I spoke the truth. You heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, he ain't giving up. I don't know what else we can do.
But I do.
Oh, right.
Oh, really, Jack? Really? Oh, only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
Oh, I never said
oh,
no!
Oh, this would be a good time to shut up! Being the boss doesn't mean you have to have all the right answers, just the brains to know the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea, the rally was Davy's, and my plan will bring us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The children's crusade.
For the sake of all the kids in every factory, sweatshop, and slaughterhouse in this city, I beg of you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being about just the Newsies. You challenged our entire generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
Children's per se.
Think, Jack. If we publish this, my words with one of your drawings, and every worker under 21 saw it and stayed home from work, better yet, came to Newsies Square, a citywide strike. Even my father couldn't ignore that.
There's only one problem. We got no way to print.
Oh, come on. There's got to be one printing press in this city that he doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know of a press that no one would ever think we use.
Then why are we still standing here?
Well, hold on. Where are you going? What's this about? For you, I don't mean the children's crusade. Am I kidding myself, or is there something?
Well, of course there's something.
Now, well, don't say it like it happens every day.
Jack.
Hey, listen, I'm no idiot. I know girls like you don't end up with guys like me, and I don't want you saying nothing you gotta take back later. But standing here tonight, looking at you, I'm scared tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there was a way I could grab a hold of something to make time stop, just as I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack.
Thank you. we meet. Who knows why? Another stranger on the street. Just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me.
We are as sure as a star.
lightning or in blood, it's the same either way.
Business elsewhere.
The old printing press in the cellar.
I gave you the offer of a lifetime. Any man who doesn't work in his own self-interest is a fool.
What's that make you? This all began because you wanted to sell more papers. But now your circulation is down 70%.
Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Guys like Joe don't talk with nothings like us. But a very wise reporter once told me, real boss don't need all the answers, just the smarts to snatch the right one when he hears it.
Have a look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you ain't figured it out, we's got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get a shoe shine or a paper. You can't send a message or ride an elevator or cross the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even leave your own building. Watch your move.
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor's here. Along with your daughter, and... Oh, you won't guess who else.
Mr. Pulitzer, I believe you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt.
Joseph, what have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation...
Thanks to Miss Meta Larkin bringing your daughter to my office, I already have a thorough grasp on the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is the expression I usually employ to show approval, but in your case... I simply mean bully. And is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told you once shared a carriage ride.
Pleasure's all mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there letting those children sing endlessly. Give them the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and rolled back prices. Unless, of course, you want to invite a full state Senate investigation into your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, I do it with a smile. Come along, Joseph. There's only one thing worse than a hard heart. That's a soft head. And think of the happiness you'll bring those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Kelly, if I may speak to you. Alone!
Keep your eyes on the stars and your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I cannot put the prices back where they were. I'm sorry, I can't. There are other considerations.
Oh, I get it. You've got a safe face in front of all these folks.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate right.
What if I decrease the raise by half and I get the other papers to do the same? It's a compromise we can all live.
But you eat our losses. From now on, any paper or news he doesn't sell, you buy back. Full price.
That was never on the table. What's to stop Newsies from buying hundreds of papers that they can't sell? My cost will explode.
No Newsies gonna break his back hauling around papers he can't sell. But if he can take a few extra with no extra risk, he might actually sell them. And your circulation will begin to increase. It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad hat you've got on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
It's just business.
Our world, and I believe the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. Your drawing son have brought another matter to bear. Officers, if you please.
Jack, look, it's Crunchy!
Yeah! Young as me!
Yeah!
Look what I grabbed you, a present straight from the restroom. Bring him in, boys! It's Snyder the Spider!
He ain't so tough now, is he?
Jack, with those drawings, shutting down the rest. Be sure that Mr. Spencer's assistant will be fully investigated. Officers,
way.
Please, Your Highness, may I do the honors?
Got to be joking.
Then you'll be laughing all the way to the pen, little man.
Sing along!
Yeah!
Yeah! Now, I was thinking, if one of your paintings could convince the governor to shut down the refuge, what might, say, a daily political cartoon do to expose the dealings in our own government's back rooms? What do you say, Teddy? Care to have this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Don't sweat it, Gov. If the strike finally settled, I probably should be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tune? What's Santa Fe got the New York ain't? Sandstorms?
Better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
New York's got us. We're family.
Now, didn't somebody say something about a strike being settled?
Tapes for the newsies! Line up, boys. These tapes ain't gonna sell themselves.
Come on, Governor. And show me this back seat I've been hearing so much about.
Well, don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. Besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Me? Work for your father.
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
And besides, you know, you've always got one more ace up your sleeve.
Well, yeah, what's that?
Me. Wherever you go, I'll be right there, by your side.
For sure.
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. It's a made-up world. Ever see. Now my eyes, they finally open, and my dreams, they're average size. But they don't much matter if you're not with me.